Sure, Jim. I actually want to just jump on something the Colonel talked about, defense in depth. What we have observed over years in the space is significant challenges with defense in depth. Specifically, we've sort of noticed this evolution from prevention tools such as antivirus to detection capabilities such as anti-malware, and now we've got detection tools such as SIEMs. And with each in an environment, there's what we would call sort of the illusion of security, but the intrinsic challenge is we continue to see issues. So our emphasis from here and moving forward and our contention would be that integration is the critical component, right? So whether or not you have these best of breed tools for a specific function, if they're not integrated and working effectively, then individual stakeholders might feel as if they're delivering a secure posture to their organization, right. But there's intrinsic challenges with that. And then in addition, the perimeter itself is fading, it's changing, right? We're in a commercial space where they're all in on cloud, the government's certainly looking that way, a lot more around applications and rapid delivery to the client, but that is leading also to undetected, unmonitored, unmaintained assets, right? Mm-hmm. So again, integration is a critical component. We've sort of taken the cybersecurity problem and broken it into sort of three critical pillars: complete visibility, the critical context associated with information coming out of all these, best of breed tools, and then all that helping to inform decisive action to our end mission users. But I think defense in depth in and of itself, great concept, but that integration is our focus. That's the key, I think, moving forward.
Excellent.